County Police Public Affairs Bureau. Thank you very much for being here. The chief of police and the sheriff of Fairfax County will be sharing information about the events that occurred at the Inova Fairfax Medical Campus last night at around 10 p.m. involving a deputy sheriff. After the chief and sheriff speak, they will take all questions from the media. At this time, I'd like to introduce the chief of police, Colonel Edwin C. Rossler. Thank you.
First, my prayers and thoughts are with everyone involved in this event today. This is a tragic loss of life. It also includes an event where someone else was injured. So again, I express my extreme condolences to all involved. Our goal of this briefing is to explain what happened with the best information that we have available at this time. Please understand that this is an active criminal investigation, and as we conduct interviews and collect evidence, what I'm about to explain may be subject to change. On August 15th, 2016, an Hispanic adult male of about 29 years old was a patient at Inova Fairfax Hospital. After being released from the hospital, security from the hospital campus staff assisted the adult male to a bus stop near the green parking garage located on Wellness Boulevard on the medical campus. Just prior to 10 p.m. last night, the hospital security received two calls for service of a report of a man at the bus stop with what appeared to be a weapon. This weapon was later determined to be a metal signpost that has a spade on the bottom, which is sharp to push into the ground to hold the sign in. You could go to our Twitter account and see a photograph of that post that I will mention several times here. Hospital security staff responded to the bus stop and observed an adult male holding the signpost, and he was acting in what appears to be a mental episode. As the security guards attempted to mitigate the event with the adult male took the post and struck one of the security guards, inflicting injury upon a security guard. This required medical attention. As security radioed for additional help and to call 911, a Fairfax County deputy sheriff on duty assigned to the hospital heard the radio traffic as per their policy to be connected to the radio traffic of the security staff while working at the hospital. The deputy sheriff then responded out to the bus stop, and at the same time, a 911 call was received by the Fairfax County Department of Public Safety Communications, and several Fairfax County police officers were responding to the medical campus, the bus stop location. The Fairfax County Deputy Sheriff, who was in full duty uniform and is crisis intervention team trained, attempted to negotiate with the adult male to de-escalate his episode. Unfortunately, the adult male raised the post and began charging at the deputy sheriff. The deputy sheriff gave orders for the adult male to cease his activity. At the same time, the man kept on coming at the deputy sheriff, while the deputy sheriff, with weapon drawn, was tactically trying to retreat. But unfortunately, the adult male kept on coming at him with the signpost in a cocked position, ready to strike. Immediately, the deputy sheriff fired his duty weapon at the adult male. The duty weapon is the issued 40 caliber Glock that the deputy sheriffs are authorized to carry on duty. The adult male was struck, and immediately the deputy sheriff, along with responding officers who just arrived shortly after the shooting, began first aid until relieved by the Fairfax County Fire and Rescue Department. Fire and Rescue Department staff then transported the adult male to the nearby emergency room at Inova Fairfax, and unfortunately, the adult male succumbed to his injuries from the gunshots. The Fairfax County Police Department's Major Crimes Division is conducting the criminal investigation of this matter. All evidence and reports will be turned over to the Fairfax County Office of the Commonwealth's Attorney for determination of any criminal liability. The Fairfax County Police Department will provide the community and all of you present here today with updates within every 30 days or as soon as new information becomes available. We do have video evidence of this event. At this time, the video is evidence. It's a crucial piece of evidence that we need to conduct our investigations. I will not be releasing the video as long as it's evidence. That is something we will deal with later on as the criminal investigation concludes. At this time, I'd like to introduce Sheriff Stacy Kincaid, Fairfax County Sheriff, who is responsible for the administrative investigation of her department. Stacy.
Good morning. I'm Sheriff Stacy Kincaid, and I'd like to thank everyone for being here this morning, along with what the chief has said regarding condolences and prayers for those involved in the incident, and of course, because it involves injury and loss of life, we share in those. Last night, my deputies were assigned to Inova Fairfax Hospital, guarding a prisoner from our adult detention center. It is our policy that deputies assigned to Inova Fairfax Hospital for prisoner guard duty monitor the hospital's security radio traffic. My deputies have both criminal and civil jurisdiction in Fairfax County, the towns of Herndon, Vienna, and the city of Fairfax, and can respond to any incident where the public safety is at risk. Once the criminal investigation has been completed by the police department, my agency will initiate the administrative investigation to determine if all of our policies and procedures were in fact followed in regards to this incident. Thank you.
At this time, we'll take any questions.
Sheriff, was the man being guarded, the suspect was the one being guarded by your deputies in the hospital?
No, that's not correct.
He was not. They were there, they transported and guarded somebody else, and then
correct.
If you could just explain that.
So there was guard duty last night at Inova Fairfax Hospital, and the deputies were doing guard duty. So they were monitoring the security radio from the hospital, and that's when the deputy responded to the incident.
Are they doing guard duty on an individual or just doing?
On an individual.
What was the suspect being treated for?
Are you talking about the deceased?
Yes.
An undisclosed medical issue that I'm not privy because of HIPAA right now. So the person was released from the hospital. As I mentioned earlier, the security staff escorted that person to the bus stop to assist the deceased with trying to get home.
Has anybody, without getting the specifics, have they informed you whether he was dealing with mental health issues generally prior to this incident?
That's part of the investigation, but it was kind of clear to us that somehow, way, shape, or form, the adult male was suffering some type of mental episode, obviously equipped with the signpost and swinging it at the hospital security staff and attempting to swing it at the deputy sheriff.
You said that security had helped him initially from the hospital to the bus stop and then eventually made the call that they saw someone with what appeared to be a weapon. Did they know it was the same individual that they had helped to the bus stop?
When the call came in, I'd be speculating as if they put one and one together at this particular point in time, but I could tell you that the intent of the security staff was to help mitigate the issue.
Can you describe the source of the video evidence? Is it a body camera video? Is it a citizen's video?
It's not body camera. The campus is under video security.
Chief, did the video capture the entire incident?
I have not seen the video yet. It's under active investigation, but I've been assured the episode's been captured on video.
Does it bear out the facts as you know them at this point?
Again, we're going to have to conduct interviews to match everything up, but it's pretty accurate as to what unfolded at this particular time. It's subject to change as we do interviews.
Chief, how long had that man been in the hospital before he was taken out to the bus stop?
I don't have that answer right now, but the investigation will determine that.
And can you speak a little bit more about the altercation he had with another security person, where that was?
At the bus stop.
So what time allowed, what time elapsed? Did he get out to the bus stop and pick up a sign and somebody called hospital security? What was the more specific sequence of events?
As mentioned earlier, specifically in my comments, he was discharged from the hospital. Security assisted to find the bus stop. They departed, it appears, and then calls came in that there was a suspicious person at the bus stop, what appeared to be armed with a weapon, and that's when security went back out to go check.
And that was when that security person was hurt?
Yes.
On that second?
On the second approach back,
yes. How seriously injured was the security person?
Treated and released.
Any sense of where, I don't know if you might have said this, where he obtained this signpost? Was it just on the ground?
It appears that there's other signs on the hospital campus that have pushed into the ground for either no parking, no smoking. So it appears that it's probably been pulled up from the ground.
Is it your sense at this point in the investigation that there was any hesitation to release him from the hospital because of perhaps any concerns about his mental state? Was he held back, or were there any discussions to hold him back?
I have no answer for that. That's going to be part of the criminal investigation. It's too early on for me to answer or even speculate on that. The signpost question, it's on our Twitter account, the exact photo.
Did he ever get on the bus, attempt to get on the bus, any bus?
I don't have any knowledge of a bus being present at that time. This happened within a matter of minutes, and we're still trying to define the timeline.
Chief, what can you tell us about the deputy, either age or number of years on the force?
I'll defer to the sheriff.
The deputy has been on the with the sheriff's office for 18 years. At this time, I'm not going to release any other pertinent information, but that will be released eventually.
The next of kin have not been notified as of yet. That's why I refer to the victim as an adult male. Once we've notified next of kin, we will give you the full name.
Does the man speak English?
I can't answer that at this particular point in time.
Hey, Chief, the sheriff's deputies normally provide security at the courthouse and for the jail. Was it appropriate, even though they have jurisdiction, was it appropriate for a sheriff's deputy to respond to this incident, or should they have waited for Fairfax County Police to arrive?
As the sheriff indicated, they do have authority in the Commonwealth of Virginia, and we work side by side for security at the hospitals, especially at the Merrifield Center, for example. We are a team together, and they provide security and transportation, and it works well for us staffing-wise. They do have authority under the Code of Virginia, as the sheriff explained.
But is it appropriate?
I think it's absolutely appropriate. That's how we do our business.
Does the deputy who did the shooting, does he speak Spanish?
I'm not aware.
Was there anybody else that came in or that interacted? I mean, there was a report of this man with a weapon. Did he possibly threaten anybody else, or?
Clearly, reports came in twice that there was a suspicious person at the bus stop with what appeared to be a weapon. So I think it's safe to assume that someone felt threatened to call. The exact number of people, I don't have that answer yet.
How many calls came in?
We know security received at least two calls, and then that prompted a 911 call.
How exactly was the security guard injured? Like, was he injured with the sign?
Struck with the signpost.
At the time the deputy arrived, were there any other civilians in the area endangered in the close proximity?
I don't have an exact number of how many people were there yet. That's part of the investigation, but we do know the security staff. Well, obviously one person was injured, and there were others there that were in harm's way, as was the deputy sheriff.
You might have said this. Where did the 911 call originate from?
I'm not at liberty to disclose information as
the
911 callers.
An individual, that's what I was asking.
Understanding that the sheriff's deputy has authority to respond to these incidents. Are the rules of engagement the same for a sheriff's deputy that they would be for a police officer?
We go to the same police academy, and we operate under the same laws of the Commonwealth of Virginia and the Department of Criminal Justice Services. And deputy sheriffs have full law enforcement authority.
Sheriff Kincaid, just to confirm, this deputy is on administrative leave, or whatever the equivalent is in the sheriff's office?
The deputy is on administrative leave, yes.
Sheriff, can you, or either sheriff or the chief, talk a little bit about the negotiation that went on? Any sort of detail about what perhaps could have been said to this man, or how long this lasted? Any details of that conversation?
I don't have specific details. Obviously, this is under investigation, and we'll have more as the investigation navigates its course. But as I said earlier, the deputy sheriff attempted to de-escalate by giving commands to clearly stop the aggressive action. And that's the best I could give you right now until further investigation is conducted.
But to be clear, this sheriff's deputy did have training in crisis intervention, especially with mental health?
Yes. The deputy did have crisis intervention training. The deputy is also assigned to the Merrifield Crisis Response Center on occasion.
Can you go into detail where the suspect was shot on his body, what may have changed in his medical status to go from non-life-threatening to life-threatening and ultimately deceased?
So the Office of the Medical Examiner will determine that. That's a medical question. We'll have to, you know, give you additional information. This is under investigation. It's only, you know, within 12 hours. I don't have many answers at this time, but we'll provide you updates as soon as we get them. Thank you.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. This concludes our press conference. If we have any other questions, I'll be more than happy to meet with you all at the conclusion of the press conference. Thank you very much.
What was the answer on how many shots have been fired?
We can discuss that right now. It's still under criminal investigation.
How much time elapsed between when the deputy arrived on the scene and the shooting occurred?
It was a very short amount of time. Probably minutes. Probably minutes.
Minutes?
Probably minutes.
And the question I have, do you know how many officers had also arrived by the time the gunshots were fired? Just trying to picture how many people.
There were numerous officers who arrived on scene shortly thereafter.
But were there any that were right? I mean, was anybody beyond the deputy involved in the negotiation? Or was it just the
deputy? No, just the sheriff's deputy was involved in a negotiation. The police officers arrived shortly thereafter.
And then at the time the shooting took place, what was the proximity of any of the other arriving officers? Was anyone else?
That's still under investigation, but we know that they weren't right in the immediate vicinity.
And these negotiations lasted, like you say, about a minute.
It could be within minutes, yeah, about minutes. Yes, that's still under investigation.
Is there any way to know whether there was a language barrier that would have prevented?
We don't know that right now.
What led officers or whoever was on the scene to believe that this man was having a mental episode?
I couldn't discuss that. I'm not sure what that information, where that information came from. And again, our Criminal Investigations Bureau is going to find that information out through the investigation.
I mean, the fact that he was escorted by security to the bus stop suggests that there was some concern to begin with. I mean, what has the hospital said to your department about that?
That's something we're going to have to find out through the investigation. When our investigators speak to the staff at Inova Fairfax Medical Campus, they'll get that information from them because the security staff there works for the Inova Fairfax.
Do you know the race of the deputy that was involved?
I do not.
Is the security staff armed?
I don't believe they are. I couldn't tell you for sure.
You said they work for the police?
No, for the Inova Fairfax Hospital. Yes.
How heavy was the signpost?
I don't know. We just posted on our Twitter account.
But the photo, I mean, for size, I mean, is there any?
There should be a size comparison graph. It looks like a little yellow ruler in the bottom left corner of the photograph.
Is it made of?
It appears to be metal.
So the thing on, oh, that's also a ruler. Okay, sorry.
Do you see it on Twitter?
I saw the label and didn't realize it was also a ruler. Okay, thank
yes, thank you.
Do you guys anticipate having another press conference today or putting out more information today?
Not today, but we in the police department will put out our 30-day updates unless we have something further that comes out as far as a break in the investigation, and we'll push it out on our social media platforms.
Do you think the ID will come today?
The ID of the victim?
Yeah.
Or the suspect?
Either one.
Okay. We don't know that yet. If the suspect's information is going to be released, that'll come through our major crimes division. If the victim deputy's information is released, that'll come.
The deceased is a Fairfax County resident? Or?
I don't know.
Can you say whether a single shot was fired or multiple shots?
We believe it was multiple shots. We don't know how many.
By just the one deputy?
Yes.
And so multiple shots, and do you know if the victim was hit multiple times?
That's under investigation still. I couldn't speak on that.
Can you tell us how close the suspect was? I know he's got
It was in close proximity, but that's still under investigation, how close the suspect was.
I forget if you guys can say this. Any previous engagements with this gentleman who's now deceased?
We're looking into that.
Can you show us exactly where the
map? It's the green, I'm sorry, I don't know if you'll be able to hear me, but it was the green garage complex, which is in this area. So this is the entire, that is a map. You can look at it on the Fairfax County, or the Inova Fairfax Hospital website. You click on parking, and it'll break out the whole complex for you. And the green the green garage would be where the incident, in close proximity, where the incident occurred.
Just outside the?
We believe it was outside the garage, not inside, but outside the garage near it.
Do you know which building the deputy was stationed in with the prisoner walk?
We don't know. We know that he was inside somewhere with, on his duty.
Are there been other cases when sheriff's deputies have responded to general calls in the county?
Yes.
How often does that happen?
It's not too, I can say from personal experience, there have been numerous calls in my 16 years where deputies have backed me up or responded to a call.
Is that basically due to proximity?
Yes, to proximity of the call. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. I appreciate it.